What's going on, guys? Spazmattic here, back inside Destiny 2, and for this video, I'm going to bring you guys a build, a guide, I guess, for this week's Grandmaster Nightfall, which is the Tree of Probabilities. Basically, every Nightfall is available this week, so basically a build for this Nightfall, Grandmaster Nightfall. So for this, we ran two Warlocks and a Titan. Both Warlocks were running Well of Radiance with Phoenix Protocol with Anarchy, Mountaintop, and Drang. Drang was used for the anti-barrier champions. We also had a Titan, Middle Tree, Sentinel, Banner, Titan, whatever you want to call it, with Ursa Furiosas to help get their super back whenever they get shot in their super. As you can see, during the strike, you'll see moments when we use the Banner Shield to our advantage to take down some of the Colossus anti-barrier champions, because they are kind of a pain to take down without one. So we use that to help us out there. And the Titan was running Divinity with I believe an Unstoppable Hand Cannon. So we were able to get rid of the Overload and Unstoppable Champions, as well as the Anti-Barriers because of our Drangs. And that's basically it. Comparing this Nightfall to the Broodhold, I would say it is a little bit more challenging. I know the boss room can be pretty difficult because it is pretty tight. It's not that big. And other than that, everything up to the boss is pretty chill. It's not too hard to get to the boss, but I'd say the boss encounter is probably the hardest part in this strike. So I think we got this on our second clear. We failed the first time because of a simple mistake. We shouldn't have really wiped because of it. But if you just play smart, like as always, play smart, have good communication, make good plays and stuff like that, you should be fine within this Grandmaster Nightfall. So this is also my final completion, or my final Grandmaster Nightfall for the Conqueror title, so you guys will see at the end of the video that I do claim that title in the end of the strike. So basically I have now every title in the game, which is pretty cool. So hopefully you guys enjoy the rest of this gameplay. I'm just going to let it play out for the rest of the video. If you guys have any questions, builds, or setups that you'd like to share, feel free to comment them down below. And if you guys enjoyed this gameplay of the Grandmaster Nightfall for the Tree of Probabilities, don't forget to rate, comment, and subscribe. And I'll see you guys later. I'm back inside Destiny 2. Peace.
Geometric data I'm reading from this architecture, it's subtly shifting, like reality trying to decide on a version it likes.
In the forest, time itself is in flux.
I don't like it.
I've alerted the Hidden to halt observation and keep clear of the forest. Your fire team is free to do its job. Good luck.
Gera, I've been meaning to ask, what are you and Osiris doing out here?
Guardian down!
I'm not completely sure yet. Some light remodeling, maybe.
The Vex won't like that.
they don't have a say.
Guardian down.
Thank you.
I've used the forest to create a simulation of your sparrow. You're gonna need it for that ramp.
A ghost can do that.
I just did. I can't tell these Cabal apart from the real thing.
What's the difference? Vex simulations can kill. These copies have the same goal as their counterparts. Find a future where the Legion wins the Red War.
Thank you. So, where's this Valis?
Wait for it.
The Vex activated their security grid.
They see you and the Cabal as invaders. Relax. It worked out fine the first time.
More lasers.
It's hard not to admire the artistry.
It's really not.
Thank you.
feel like we've done this before.
Why do you keep asking that? I was the active ghost last time. Now it's you.
I've never asked that.
Huh. I swear you did.
There's something strange about this forest.